The Prophet ﷺ said, reported in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, that the Mahdi shall be from the Ahlul Bayt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rectify him in one night, will make him good in one night. This is an interesting hadith because it tells us that the Mahdi in the younger portion of his life will not be as practicing of a Muslim as he should be. He will not be to the level that he is worthy of being. Something will happen, we don't know what. And in one night, he shall repent. And he shall become basically the most pious person on earth. He will not be born like this. He will not be raised as an alim and since the beginning memorize the Quran. No, this is not the case of the Mahdi. The Mahdi, we don't know what level, but it says that in one night Allah will purify him and correct him. Allah will yuslih. Yuslih means he wasn't salih before. He wasn't pious before. So the Mahdi will not be to the level of piety that we would expect him to be. In one night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then cause him to repent. As Ibn Kathir said, he will repent from his ways and he will become basically the most pure person on earth. We also know that in the times that he will come, we said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clearly said that the time shall be of the worst of times. That the entire earth shall be filled with evil and injustice. And that is something that very rarely happens. That the entire earth, you see fitna and fasad. And you see Muslim blood being shed. And you see the Muslims being humiliated everywhere you look. Hardly ever has this occurred in the Ummah. That when it does occur, that is one of the times that we can expect that there to come a Mahdi figure. Now the question arises, where shall he appear from? Of course, the timing, nobody knows. If we knew when the Mahdi will appear, we will know when Isa will come and Dajjal will come. And then we will know when the Day of Judgment will come roughly. Nobody knows. And I have read many articles in English and seen references in Urdu, certain people now spreading, the Mahdi will appear in this year. And they mention a specific year. And they have calculated this from I don't know how. Anytime somebody makes a prediction, any prediction, you can guarantee he is a liar. Allah says in the Quran, no one knows what will happen tomorrow. No one knows. Anybody says that on this day this will happen, and on this time and this year this will happen, this person is lying. Either he is crazy and the pen has been lifted from him, so Allah will not punish him, or he is a Dajjal pretending to know ilm al-ghayb. One of the two. Cannot be anything other than this. Any time a prediction is made, such a person is not an alim to make this prediction. So the timing of the Mahdi, nobody knows. And we should not even estimate. We should not say, oh, we are living in a time of fitna and fasad, perhaps this is the time. No, only Allah knows. Only Allah knows. And by the way, we don't want to be alive when the Mahdi comes. Why? Because right after the Mahdi, the Dajjal will come. In his lifetime, the Dajjal will come. And the Prophet ﷺ said, there is no fitna that mankind has been afflicted with that is worse than the Dajjal. From the beginning of times until the Day of Judgment, there is no fitna that is more severe to mankind than the Dajjal. We don't want to be alive when the Dajjal comes. And when the Mahdi comes, in his lifetime the Dajjal will come. So we don't want to see that timing. And we seek Allah's refuge from being alive at that time. So don't sit there and say, oh inshallah he's coming soon. Because you don't want to be at that time when all of these fitan will occur. Only Allah knows when the Mahdi will come.